finally, for distant learning, I'm going to show you how you can use Snowflake, which is the other piece of software that we package with our Clevertouch screens, along with links. Now, Snowflake is an online community of teachers all over the world creating interactive activities. And what's great is that from a one teacher account, you can create student accounts and send content directly out to them. So I'm going to show you how to do that. At the minute, this is the website for the community itself that I can scroll through all the different activities or search for them. Anything you click on will then become part of your activities. So you can go to your lesson activity area. And what's really great is that you can group lessons into lists. And there are tutorials online that will show you how to do that. You know, if you create a new list, you just select the activities you want to be part of it. So I've got quite a few lists here that I could send out to students. Now, to get them ready to send them out, what's quite nice is that you can add extra resources to the interactive activities. So for example, I can add an audio recording, so some instructions. So if I want to do that, I can use the microphone on my screen here, but of course I could be just creating this on my laptop, which is connected to the screen anyway. So I'm going to record some audio. Here we go. How many ways of making the long O vowel sound do you know? Write them down. Now that's recorded, I can save it, and it will become added to the list. So if I just tap this little arrow here, you can see that the audio recording is there, and I can play that back just to double check that it works.
How many ways of making long O vowel sound do you know? Write them down.
Fantastic. And if I go back to my list here, I could get ready to send this out to students. Now, another great thing is that I could add PDFs to the list as well. So in here, it says add PDF, and I'd basically go to my browser and be able to select the files I'd like to add in. Now, to give you an example of that, I've got some myth spinners here that help children generate a story plan. And as we go across, you can see that as well as a word search activity, there's a voice recording of some instructions, and there's a PDF added to that. So all of those would get sent out to the students at the same time. And to do that, again, from the options here, you would click send to students and then choose which students you're going to send them to. So I've got some classes set up here. So I can come in here, have a look at all the students in my class. I can uncheck them all and just send the file to just one particular student. So if you've got a class of children and only two or three of them are learning from home, you can just pick those two or three children to send the content out to them, or you can select all of them and send it out to everyone at once. When you want to send it out, it gives it the date that it was sent out to the students, and also you can put in due date if you want to know that they've responded by a certain time. And you can also select to notify the students via email that they've got some lessons to do. If I want to create a class of students, it's really easy to do. I can import a CSV of emails or from ClassLink or even from Google Classroom as well. Or I can even just create an account for individual students, and I don't even need an email address, just their name, and Snowflake will create a username and a password for them and add them into the class that you've selected. So it's really quick and easy to do, and it means that you can send out interactive activities to your students. So that's Snowflake for interactive activities, Zoom for live lessons, and links recordings for students to be able to catch up with some of the lessons that you might have performed at your Clevertouch board earlier in the day. So here I am, a student. I've logged onto my snow.live account as a pupil on my iPad. I can scroll down. These are all the lessons that my teacher has sent out to me. And for example, here is a list linked to myth spinners. So if I click on those, they will load in. And each activity has an instruction. And then I can do the activity. So this first one comes with a nice little bit of animation, and I have a wheel to spin to help me generate a story plan. So I'm going to write a story in a desert, and then I'm going to go to the next activity. And again, another wheel to spin to give me a monster. Okay, so I'm gonna have a Minotaur in the desert. And the next one, I'm choosing a hero for my story. Or a brave peasant fighting a Minotaur in the desert. And finally, again, I'm going to have a plot for my story. So the brave peasant is trying to break a curse by killing a Minotaur in the desert. Then, as a bit of fun, there's a word search included as an activity, and I need to complete that before I can go on to the next activity. So some of the activities where there's something to actually do, need to complete that and then go on to the next step. And I know there's a couple of PDFs added on there as well for this activity. So content sent out to students. Now, a nice bonus feature of Snowflake that you can use for live lessons only is the polls. So if I go to my lesson activities, I can go to some polls that I've created. So we'll have a look at the one that I use for my Clevertouch demos. And normally you would just join in with a QR code. I'm just going to stop that for a moment. And just to show you what kind of thing you can do. So if I was going to add a question in, what's great is the questions that you can put into polls are yes and no questions, multiple choice, where someone will choose on their device, type in their own answer, find an image from their device and send that as an answer, or text with image, and they can even draw images if you're feeling really brave. When you've got all your questions ready and you want to start, it basically produces a QR code. So if you're doing this in class and your students have a device like I have, I'm in class, I've got my device, I will be able to join the poll. But what's great is because you don't have to be on the same Wi-Fi, if you're sending this lesson out live via Zoom, then all of your students watching this lesson on Zoom can hold up another device, such as their phone, and join in the meeting. There's two ways of doing it. They can just go to this website, answer.it, and type in the 4-digit code, or they can use their camera and scan the QR code, as I'm going to attempt to do now. So I'm now into the meeting, asking me to add my name. So I am in the meeting. So there I am. I'm the one student in this lesson. So the teacher now can choose to hide all the questions and just start the actual poll. So here we go. First question is, have I enjoyed the presentation? And I've got 10 seconds to click yes. And the results reveal 100% success. My next question here is all about the software that I'm interested in. Now, I love all the software, but I better choose Snowflake in this instance, since that's what we're using. Fantastic. And then another multiple choice question here about the features of our impact boards. We have split screen features, clever share so that you can link devices like iPads to the screen, the crop tool that you can use at any time, and of course the clever store with our over 200 educational apps. I'm going to go for the crop tool there. Everyone has answered. Let's see the results. Fantastic. And then finally, what is your favorite football team? Now, not being a huge football fan myself, I better put this in or my father-in-law and mother-in-law will kill me, as Coventry supporters. Sorry, everyone else out there. There we go. Submit my answer. And there it is. It's come up on the screen live. So that's the polls feature that will help you do remote learning. Thank you.